Kenwood TS2000. 10 meter FN is a lot of fun. I meet so many different people. There's a lot of different repeaters on 10 meters. And one of the things you have to do is, one, know the offset for 10 meters. And the offset for 10 meters is actually 100 kilohertz. So we're going to program this frequency in, and we want to go down 100. When we transmit, we want to go 29.520. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to hit to see what the offset is set on. So we get the function key, and then we're going to put the shift or offset. See the zero, it says offset. So when we push that button, we look over here, and it says offset. It has 0 kilohertz. So what we'll do is we'll go to multi-channel knob, and we start turning it until we get 100 kilohertz. This is the frequency on 10 meters that will go down on the repeaters, 100 kilohertz. Once we have the offset set, we push the function and the shift key. Now, to make sure that we want to go down, we have to hit just the shift key. And when we hit the shift key, you'll see, I think right above the 9 or the 6, a minus comes on. Up above the 2. If you push it again, it'll go back to nothing. If you push it once, it'll be positive. It'll go up 100. Or you go make it negative when you hit the negative. Also, on this particular repeater, we want a tone of 146.2. So what we do is we have to go again on our function key. We push the 4 for the tone, and when we do, it says the subtone is at 88.5. We want to go to 146. So what I'm sorry, I forgot to show you. What I'm doing is moving the multi-channel key, and I'm moving it till I get 146.2. There it is. That's our subtone. Now what we'll do is we'll have the function, hit the tone, and that's programmed in there for this particular one. So what we'll do is we'll have to hit the tone to make sure it's on, and somewhere around above the 9 or the 6 should be a T when I push the number 4. All right, there it is. So now we're receiving on 29.620. We have an offset minus, which we already programmed for 100 kilohertz, and we have a tone of 146.2. Now let's say you want to program this frequency, and I want to just show you it real quick. When we hit transmit, it'll go down 100 kilohertz. So when we key up, it should go to 29.520. There it is, 29.520. All right, that works great. So we want to program this into the memory. What we do is we hit this MN right here. And when we do, it shows you all the list of the channels, the multi-channel. This is programmed for 2 meters right now. I have different frequency. I'll come over here to the multi-channel, and I'm going to turn it until the frequency just goes blank. The multi-channel will still, memory channels will still be. So set 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. It's blank. So then I can hit memory in. When I did, this pops back up. Now to make sure it's in our memory, let's push the VFO M. And when we do, the channel numbers will come up. Again, that's 31. Now if you just want to go through the channels, you hit this multi-channel, turn it, and it'll go through all the frequencies you've got in your channels. If you want to scan it, it's good to have your squelch turned up. You turn the squelch, this volume, turn the squelch. And then when you push the scan button, watch these numbers. And it'll stop it. If you don't want to go there, it'll go on after about 5 seconds. And there's another channel it stops on, but it'll keep on going. And let's say you hear someone that you want to listen to. So what you do is when you finally hear someone you want to listen to, you can stop the scan by just hitting the scan button. Okay, I hit the, and it's no longer scanning. And if you want a manual scan, so to speak, through your channels that you've got programmed, you just turn your multi-channel key. And there it goes. So that's how you program and set up your...
One more cigarette. Great.
Your memories on 10 meters. Thanks for watching.